With science still being considered a man's profession in much of the world, we figured we'd enlighten those with a gender bias on the issue with some incredible scientific women. Here, we've collected many of those who have won one of the most recognized and respected awards around. This is 15 Scientific Women with the Nobel Prize. 15. May Britt Moser. Miss Moser is a dedicated neuroscientist and psychologist from Norway, and she worked at the Norwegian University of Science and Technology as the department head for the Center of Neurocomputation. Moser's work on grid cells in our brain's entorhinal cortex, plus other cells inside the same circuit that help us to form positioning systems in the brain, earned her half a Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 2014. She shared the half prize with her then husband, Edvard Moser. John O'Keefe, another neuroscientist, won the other half of the prize. There have only been 5 couples to receive the Nobel jointly, and the Mosers are one of them. 14. Carol W. Greider and Elizabeth Blackburn. Elizabeth Blackburn is a scientist who specialized in molecular biology and received her bachelor's and master's degree at the University of Melbourne. She then went on to become the president of the Salk Institute for Biological Sciences. Carol Greider is an American molecular biologist who was a graduate student under Elizabeth Blackburn at the University of California, Berkeley, and it was there that she discovered telomerase, an enzyme, in 1984. She then pioneered research into telomeres, a structure on the end of each chromosome comprised of repetitive nucleotide sequences that help to protect from fusion to other chromosomes and deterioration. She, along with the help of Blackburn and Jack W. Szostak, discovered that the enzyme telomerase protects the telomeres from progressive shortening, and this earned the three the Nobel Prize for Physiology or Medicine in 2009. 13. Ada Ionat. This young lady grew up poor in Jerusalem, and when her father passed away, she moved to Tel Aviv and went to Tishan Hadash High School. She couldn't even afford to pay tuition at the school, so it was arranged that she would tutor students in math in exchange for schooling. She ended up at the Weizmann Institute of Science, where she earned a Ph.D. in X-ray crystallography in 1964, and she established the first protein crystallography lab in the country of Israel. She was the pioneer in cryobiocrystallography and faced supremely harsh criticism for doing so by the scientific community. In 2009, she received the Nobel Prize for Chemistry for work on peptide bond formation and protein biosynthesis. But we owe her more than that. We know things like why there are some drug-resistant bacterias and exactly how many antibiotics work, rather than just knowing that they do. She pushed through adversity, and in the structural biology of today, her cryobiocrystallography taught us a standard technique. 12. Frances Barré-Sanozzi. Frances Barré-Sanozzi studied at the Pasteur Institute of Paris, where she earned a PhD in 1975 and began to study retroviruses. Just 8 years later, in 1983, she and her mentor, Luc Montagnier, discovered HIV, and since then figured out how it spreads and found its connection to AIDS. She and Montagnier won the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 2008 for their discovery of the devastating virus. 11. Linda Buck. Dr. Linda Buck is a biologist who earned bachelor's degrees in both microbiology and psychology at the University of Washington in 1975. She went on to get a PhD in immunology from the University of Texas Southwestern Medical Center at Dallas in 1980. She began to attempt to map out the olfactory process at the molecular level during her postdoctoral research in the 1980s, which produced excellent results. In 1991, she, along with Dr. Richard Axel at Columbia University, published their findings of a whole family of genes that code for 1,000-plus odor receptors in our nose's olfactory neurons. It is this groundbreaking work that earned the two the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 2004. 10. Christiane Nusslein-Wahlhaut. This German developmental biologist went to school at the University of Tübingen, where she earned her PhD in 1974. In 1995, she, along with Eric Vieskaus and Edward B. Lewis, won the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for work on the genetic control of embryonic development. Specifically, they studied fruit fly embryos, with the goal of identifying specific genes that played a role in their development. She has spent her career focusing on the genetic mechanisms which allow single cells to develop into multicellular organisms. Her work has helped the world understand evolution better, and it's also aided in our understanding of the process of development, as well as which genes are involved in each process. 9. Gertrude B. Elion. Elion was an American pharmacologist and biochemist who developed and helped develop many new drugs throughout her lifetime. She went to Hunter College, where she graduated with a degree in chemistry in 1937, then earned a master's in science in 1941 from New York University. She was unable to secure any type of graduate research position due to gender biases at the time, and was left working for a food lab in New York and A&P supermarkets as a food quality supervisor. After a time, she found a position at the Burroughs Wellcome Pharmaceutical Company as an assistant to George W. Hitchings. Elion developed many anti-cancer drugs while at Burroughs Wellcome, and in 1988, she, Hitchings, and Sir James Black won the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for their discoveries of important new principles of drug treatment. 8. Rita Levi-Montalcini. Our next Nobel laureate was born in Turin, Italy, and almost became a writer instead of a doctor. But after seeing one of her family's close friends pass away from stomach cancer, she changed her mind. She attended the University of Turin, where she graduated in 1936 summa cum laude as an MD. She earned a research fellowship at Washington University in St. Louis in Professor Victor Hamburger's lab, and eventually, Professor Hamburger offered her a research associate position, which she accepted and worked for 30 years. In 1952, in the lab at Washington University, she and colleague Stanley Cohen isolated nerve growth factor, and it is for this work that they won the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 1986. Levi-Montalcini went on to be given the position of Senator for Life in 2001 by Carlos Azeglio Ciampi, the President of Italy at the time. In 2009, she became the first ever Nobel laureate to hit 100 years old. She held her position in the Senate until she passed away, at which point she was also the oldest living Nobel laureate. 7. Barbara McClintock. McClintock was a scientist and cytogeneticist, and she earned a Ph.D. in 1927 from Cornell University. She then jumped right in feet first and became the leader in developing the field of maize cytogenics. Maize is another word for corn, and it was to study the chromosomes of corn and how they change and develop as it reproduces that McClintock dedicated the rest of her life. She won many awards and was also awarded many prestigious fellowships throughout her career. She was also the only woman ever to win a Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine that isn't shared with anyone else. She won the prize because of her discovery of transposition, which is a transposable element within DNA that can move around a genome and alter genome size and the genetic identity of cells, and can sometimes reverse or create mutations. 6. Rosalyn Sussman Yalow. When the Second World War broke out, many men were sent off to war, but universities stayed open, which meant there was availability in the schools and scholarships available to those who wanted to attend. Rosalyn Yalow took advantage of the openings and got a scholarship at the University of Illinois, where she earned a Ph.D. in physics. When she was finished, she moved on and helped set up a radioisotope lab at the Bronx Veterans Administration Hospital. She, along with Solomon Bearson, came up with a way to measure trace amounts of substances in liquids, called radioimmunoassay. RIA is used to measure levels of insulin, vitamins, hormones, enzymes, and is quite essential in testing for many diseases, including cancer. It can help measure drugs in a person's bloodstream and screen donated blood for impurities and disease, and it's been quite successful, understandably. For her work, she won the 1977 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine alongside Andrew V. Chalet and Roger Guillaume. 5. Dorothy Hodgkin. Hodgkin's passion for science was fostered by her mother as a child, which led her to a women's-only Oxford college, where she studied chemistry. She eventually made it to the University of Cambridge, where she earned a Ph.D., and it was there that she first fell in love with X-ray crystallography. She then moved back to Oxford, took a position as the first research chemistry fellow at the university, and studied the structure of proteins. There, in 1945, she confirmed penicillin structure, discovered insulin structure, and mapped B12. It was the mapping of B12 that, in 1945, got her a Nobel Prize in Chemistry. 4. Maria Goeppart-Mayer. Goeppart-Mayer chose to study physics and mathematics at the University of Göttingen, and in 1930 earned her doctorate in philosophy. Her dissertation was on two-photon absorption, something that couldn't be proven at the time, but was in 1961, so the two-photon absorption cross-section unit was named the Goeppart-Mayer unit, or GM unit. Upon graduation, she moved to the United States and worked in the physics department at Johns Hopkins University as an assistant. She also worked at Columbia University, then the Manhattan Project, then Los Alamos Laboratory, and then Argonne National Laboratory. Goeppart-Mayer came up with the nuclear shell model at Argonne, which earned her a Nobel Prize in Physics, along with Eugene Paul Wigner and J. Hans D. Jensen. 3. Gertie Cori. This biochemist moved with her husband Carl to America from Austria in 1922. And there, they both worked in New York, at the Roswell Park Cancer Institute. Their focus was on carbohydrate metabolism, primarily because Gertie's father had diabetes and asked her to try and find a cure for him. They worked together, and Gertie even got to have first author credit on their papers, which suggested that Gertie did the majority of the research. She and Carl discovered glycogen metabolism, which is what they won the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for in 1947. She was the first ever woman to win that specific prize, and she was also the first ever American woman to win a Nobel Prize in Science. 2. Irene Joliot-Curie. You may recognize this one's last name. That's because she is the daughter of Marie and Pierre Curie, so it should come as no surprise that she was the second woman to win a Nobel Prize. She and Jean-Frédéric Joliot-Curie, her husband, won the Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 1935 for discovering artificial radioactivity. Both of the Joliot-Curie's children, Pierre and Helena, are also successful scientists as well. Can you guess which family has the most Nobel Prizes, with 4 in total given to 5 family members? That's right, it's the Curies. Even without Pierre and Helena having Nobel Prizes. Yet. We've seen some amazing women so far, and we still have the top spot left. But first, we'd like to ask, who are some of the most inspiring and talented women you know? Do any of them measure up or surpass any of the women on this list? Let us know in the comments below. 1. Marie Curie. Marie Curie was the first woman ever to win a Nobel Prize, and she did so in the category of physics with her husband, Pierre, and Henri Becquerel in 1903. Now, you might think that being the first woman to win a Nobel Prize is impressive, but what would you think if we told you she won another one in a different category as well? In 1911, she won the prize again, this time in chemistry, making her the first person, not just woman, ever to win 2 Nobels. During her career, she discovered several elements, worked on the development of X-rays, was a University of Paris professor, designed ways to isolate radioactive isotopes, and developed the theory of radioactivity. She's part of and started the Curie family legacy of Nobel laureates. If you enjoyed this video, do us a favor and give it a like. Subscribe to our channel so that you always catch our excellent uploads. And check out this next video we just know you're going to love.